Hello everyone, and welcome to another short news video. It seems that Suyu, the most promising emulator to replace Yuzu, is coming in full force and striving to avoid the same mistakes as its predecessor. Firstly, even the name of the emulator is somewhat provocative, a pun that challenges the big N. If you haven't caught it yet, read it again, Suyu. As mentioned earlier, Suyu is determined not to repeat the same mistakes as Yuzu. Thus, the emulator will not use the old prod.keys methods. Instead, users will have to decompile games using their own tools for that. This process has been used before in the early development of Yuzu. So, you might be wondering, do I have to download a game in XCI or NSP and then decompile it to have all the necessary files to make it work? The answer is both yes and no. Initially, yes, you will need to convert the existing game library to work properly on Suyu. But part of the answer is no, and I'll explain it in another way. For those who have used Xbox 360 games, they know that there are two types of formats accepted by the emulator on the internet: the traditional ISOs, encrypted in the same way as XCI or NSP files. In just one ISO file, you have the entire structure for the game to work, or you can simply download a file in RGH or JTAG format. These second types of files have already been decrypted by others and are ready to use, without any further processes. Another example of this is games on CMU, which needed to be converted to loading format to be used on CMU. Over time, there will be websites that will have a whole collection of only decrypted games, just like what happens with Citra and some other sites that already provide CHDs for you to use on PCSX2 or NetherSX2. I hope this explanation is clear. Therefore, once the emulator becomes popular, decryptions will no longer be necessary. If the emulator will not use prod.keys, then it does not violate any Nintendo rights. Another important news, especially coming from the emulation community, is that, as I have mentioned several times, this community is not always the friendliest on the internet. They were responsible for the shutdown of EtherSX2, as they were directly threatening the creator and his family. Additionally, some projects have toxic communities on Discord. However, people have come together for Suyu. Some of the old programmers who were part of Yuzu have already joined this new project, greatly speeding up the development time. Developers have also been able to compile the first builds, and the emulator's website is almost ready. However, the process of getting games to run without any encryption may take some time, perhaps even months. Additionally, on Suyu's Discord, there are indications that the emulator will have versions for macOS and also Android, in addition to the Windows version. This could be a new light at the end of the tunnel for those who enjoy playing on Android. And if you're enjoying these daily news videos, please don't forget to leave your like so that the platform can further promote this content. And if this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to receive all future updates. As for Ryujinx, as I mentioned earlier, some developers have already decided to abandon the project. Since there is no company behind the project, as was the case with Yuzu, if Nintendo wants to sue, they will have to sue each developer individually. However, the project is not immune to this, as they use prod.keys to make the games work. If Suyu manages to implement what they are planning, which is to use decrypted games, Ryujinx could include this in their code, as both projects are open source, thus escaping Nintendo's lawyers. We also have good news for 3DS emulation. While Citra had to be discontinued, as it was managed by the same team as Yuzu, Citra did not directly suffer major attacks from Nintendo, since the 3DS is already a discontinued console. With Nintendo shutting down any way for you to obtain new games and even the ability to play some games online this year, Citra found itself in a delicate situation. To replace Citra, we have Lime. Unlike Suyu, Lime may have a shorter path ahead, as Citra did not require any decryption process. As mentioned earlier, you already use tools to decrypt the game instead of the process being done by the emulator. The Lime developer is already a legendary figure in the community. On his GitHub page, he left the following message: "Emulation does not die, it changes and advances." This, in a way, could be a direct challenge to Nintendo. Once there is any public build of these projects, both for Windows and Android, I plan to test them for you and compare them directly with the old versions. Are you excited about the new era approaching, or do you think only the creators can make the most of their projects? Let me know your opinions in the comments. For now, those are the updates. Once there is more information, I'll be posting it for you. Thank you for your viewership, and until the next video.